Now let's look at how to create a base inside of your Obsidian vault. There are basically three options available to you for creating a base. The first option is to create a new base file. So if you hit Command P to invoke the command palette and then type the name bases, you can see the commands that are available based off of the core plugin now being enabled. As a side note, whenever you install a new plugin, whether it's a core plugin or a community plugin, typing the name of the plugin that you just installed is a great way to discover the commands that the plugin enables. In this case, we have two commands available, create new base and insert new base. So the first option here is to create a new base. Let's select this option and hit the Enter key to create a new base file, which as you can see in the file explorer on the left now is named untitled, but there is a visual indication on the right side of this entry that this is a base file. So this is a different type of file than the standard Markdown files. What this base file does is give you a view of the notes that match the criteria that you have set in the filter for this base. Because we just created this base, there aren't any filters applied. So it's actually showing us a table view of all 32 files that are in our Obsidian vault. As we apply filters, some of these notes will not show up in this table view. But when you first create a base and there aren't any filters applied, it shows everything in your vault. Now, what's impressive about this to me is how quickly it shows the results of this base filter. Even when I create a new base inside of my personal Obsidian vault, which has over 50,000 notes, the results are displayed instantly in this view. Okay, so that's the first option for creating a base. Let's create a new note and take a look at the second option. So we'll just go to an empty line here, hit Command P to invoke the command palette once again, search for bases again, and this time let's select Insert New Base. Now what this does, you can see in the code there, is it creates a new base. In this case, it's untitled1.base because untitled.base already exists. And it has a link to that base, but it also has the exclamation point on the left, which means that the file is going to be transcluded in the note or embedded. So it created the new base, it applied the filter, but what this really did is it created that note and then it created the link to that note and embedded it in this file. All right, so let's select this text and get rid of this and we'll see that the base goes away. Now there's one additional way that you can create a base, and that is with a base code block. This does not create a new base file, but gives you all of the same functionality inside of an embedded base in a note. So to add a base's code block, just type three backticks, then the word base. Okay, and because I have live preview enabled, when I go to a line that's outside of the code block, you can see it renders the base just like we saw earlier, but this base is completely contained inside of this new note file. It does not exist anywhere else in my Obsidian vault. Now, regardless of how you added your base, whether you created the base file in the file explorer, you embedded the base, or you used the base's code block like I just showed you, all of the bases work the same way. There's a filter that gets applied, and the selected properties get displayed in the type of view that you choose. So right now we've got a table view. We'll look at views in a little bit, but for right now, I just want to show you how the filters work. To apply a filter, you just need to click the filter button up here at the top above the table view. Now you can apply filters to all views or this specific view. We just have one view right now, the table view. We'll look at the different types of views in a moment, but for now, let's apply a filter to all views. So this is a filter that's going to select certain files to be displayed in all views of this base. But if you have filters for all views and then add additional filters for specific views, you can layer these things on top of one another, which is pretty cool. Now, all the filters work the same way. You select the conditions, so all of the following are true is the default. We can also select any of the following are true or none of the following are true. I'm just going to use all of the following are true for now. And then you choose the file property that you want to use as the filter. So here we have file, but we also have a whole bunch of other properties which are either inherent in the file metadata or properties that we have added to notes in our Obsidian vault. So before we go any further, we actually need to go make sure that the properties are turned on. So properties you can add to any note, but it's easiest if you go to the settings here, you go to the core plugins and you make sure that you have this properties view option toggled on, because this allows you to see the metadata for your notes in the sidebar. You can select and manipulate specific properties, but you can also add these to the top of a note using 3 backticks. That's actually what I'm going to do for new note. So let's go here. Because this is an embedded view, we can go down into the note and then type 3 dashes. That adds a properties section at the top of our note where we have 3 different types of properties: aliases, CSS classes, and tags. Now, we've covered properties in previous videos, so I'm not going to go too deep into this, but for the sake of using these, let's just select the tags option. And then to apply a tag to this note, all we need to do is type the tag that we want to use. All right, and now let's go to the filter for this base. And if we go to all views, we can set it so that it shows only the files that have that specific tag. So let's search for tags. Once we select the property we want, there's a bunch of conditions that can be met: is exactly, is not exactly, is empty, contains any of, contains all of, is not empty, does not contain any of. You get the idea. And let's choose contains and then type our example tag. Okay, so as you can see, we now have the one note in this base that has that tag applied. And if we go to a new note and add the tag, it will instantly show up here. So let's go to the vault is just a local folder note and add a tag here. All right, now let's go back to the new note we were just at. And now we have 2 notes that are listed in this table.